Hi and welcome back from Øredev with the Night Hacking interviews. And now we have a new guest, Krzysztof Zabłocki.
Hello.
So hi, and please introduce yourself. What are you doing?
I'm an iOS consultant. I work as a lead engineer in New York Times currently. And I do a lot of open source. Mm-hmm. I have a lot of popular libraries on GitHub. And I focus on making, basically what I try to do is make teams more efficient, make mm-hmm. life easier for other iOS developers in the community.
Right. And well, the New York Times app, I guess.
Yeah.
And that's probably like a huge one, right? With a lot of downloads.
Millions of downloads. It's amazing content. We have amazing writers. And so the iOS application is basically make it more accessible for people. Mm-hmm. So you don't need the paper. You can actually read it on device, on the go.
Right.
And that's the basic goal of our application. And we recently rewrote the whole application from scratch.
Okay.
Last year, like over the last year, we were rewriting it. We recently released it. It's all written in Swift. It's all mm-hmm. test-driven as mm-hmm. well. So pretty interesting project. I work with around 10 engineers.
Wow. And so once you have a really huge app, but an app with a lot of users, how does it affect your development? Because I think you still have to like change things as opposed to have an app that, you know, 100 guys use.
So the thing is, the ratio of users to developers, it's crazy, right? Because
right.
we have millions of users and only 10 engineers working on the app.
Oh, okay.
On the iOS application. Uh-huh. So that means that you get a lot of reports. Like you get a lot of bug reports, a lot of crashes, even with like, you know, testing and everything, you mm-hmm. still will have problems, right? It doesn't cover everything. So we need to find ways to make it easier to find bugs before they end up in mm-hmm. production.
Mm-hmm.
So the goal for me as a lead engineer is to try to find ways for us to be more efficient as developers and to avoid the potential bugs that mm-hmm. the users would see.
Right.
So a lot of the, like I do a lot of dev tooling mm-hmm. around finding issues before they surface.
Right.
So for example, a common problem with iOS is you get memory leaks or mm-hmm. retain cycles. So the objects get never deallocated. They keep occupying the memory.
Mm-hmm.
And what happens at some point, if you use too much memory, the system kills you. So we
okay.
want to avoid that,
yeah,
right?
Sure.
So like I recently released a tool that surfaces those kind of problems as you develop the feature mm-hmm. rather mm-hmm. than an afterthought. Because
right.
there is tooling from Apple to find memory leaks and retain cycles. But by the time you usually use it, it's a little too late
mm-hmm.
because a lot
mm-hmm.
of changes happened. And then you run it and you see there is a retain cycle. And then you have a git diff that's huge.
Right.
And where did you cause it? It's a little hard to track. So the tooling I made is very simple. But what it does is as you develop the feature, if there is a bug, a UI appears in your
mm-hmm.
application saying that there is too many objects of this type.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And it helps you to realize, okay, I made some mistake, but your diff is
early
now much
process.
Smaller, right?
Mm-hmm.
So you can find the problem before you send a PR.
Absolutely. Well, this sounds really interesting. And you're also giving a presentation here at Øredev. What's that about?
I'm talking about Sourcery, which is one of the tools I made. It's extending the Swift language to have code generation or like metaprogramming.
Oh, okay. mm-hmm.
So Swift is strongly typed language, mm-hmm. right? It doesn't have any of the Objective-C used to be very based on runtime, reflection. You could do a lot of
mm-hmm.
magic, right?
Mm-hmm.
Magic is risky, but code generation, so you can avoid boilerplate, is something you would want to have, right?
Mm-hmm.
So for example, in Swift, you had to manually write equality. So to be able to compare two instances
mm-hmm.
at the same time, you have
right.
to implement the function for comparison. Or you have to do like generate JSON from that.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a lot of use cases like that, that the language didn't do. They started implementing this recently. Partially because of the tooling.
Okay.
Sourcery has been used in 7,000 projects already.
Oh, wow.
And it kind of pushed the community need forward. Like this is important to have
mm-hmm.
automatic equality, automatic hashing, automatic encoding to JSON. And so Apple actually implemented most
mm-hmm.
of that already. Like there's in the newest Swift language, they're still finishing up the implementation.
Yeah, that's great.
Yeah, but the tool can be used for so much more.
Mm-hmm.
Like. The amount, like you can generate stops and mocks for your tests automatically. you can implement better architectures because you get rid of the boilerplate that would stop you otherwise from using a specific approach. And if it's automated, there's no pain, right? And you can do something that actually uses more types and it's more safe to write and execute. So Sourcery basically scans your source code, it builds abstract syntax tree, and then it feeds it to templates. So you define the algorithm template, and that gets implemented in your project.
Okay, so that sounds very sophisticated, not just like a simple template, but really fit and tailor it to your specific project.
It's completely not, like, it's not opinionated. It does what you want it to do. You basically get the metadata about your types. So you, for example, you know that your type has five properties. Those are the name of the properties. Mm-hmm. Those are the types. And from that, you can generate a lot of code.
Wow, this sounds really interesting. Actually, is it your first time here at Øredev?
Yes, here, first time.
Okay, so what is your experience so far?
I like it.
What's your impression?
The venue is nice. Yeah. There's a lot of companies here that are known, and the way it's organized is pretty good. Yeah, I do a lot of talks, so I travel a lot. Next week I'm speaking in Riga on DevFest. So. Uh-huh. I travel a lot.
You do a lot of the mobile and iOS conferences?
Yes, yes, iOS mostly. Yeah.
Okay, that's very interesting. And now you are you based in New York then?
If it's no, I work remotely.
Oh.
I work remotely for 4 years now in different companies. I worked Mashable before New York Times, which is also a news company, and just so happens. And I work for Warsaw, so fully remote.
Okay, yeah. that was... Okay, that's very interesting. Okay, any other last things you want to share with the audience, maybe for folks who cannot attend the Øredev conference?
I would recommend everyone to try out Sourcery. If you do iOS development, I mean, it will, like, I promise it will save you a lot of time, probably more weeks than hours, because it gets rid of a lot of potential human mistakes. And I think that's a huge win for engineering in general.
Absolutely. All right, then thanks a lot for the interview. And for you, thanks for watching. Bye.